Hello, guys! So nice of you to join me. My name is Hoody, and welcome back to Outlast,
the Whistleblower DLC.
So yeah, I don't actually know what to say about this. I don't want to run from the military. I mean, they have automatic rifles. I mean, some limping away won't help me that much. I don't turn back. Don't turn around. Yeah, go to the basement. Is that the guy with the bat that chased me in the first game?
He's like killing every guy. Don't go in my basement. That's mine. Oh god.
Can I jump off the window again? I mean, that's a common thing in those games. Oh god, what was that? I don't think I should open any more doors, just go with the flow. Oh. It's morning, or is just the fire? Hey, is that the morning, or is just the fire that burning down the church? Oh god. What? That's one locked door. Hey, this looks like the first. Hey, is this the first? Did Miles enter through here? Wait. There was a door, and there was a room with a broken window. Is that the? No. I hope I'm not gonna get shot like Miles did. I really hope that. I mean, I want to leave. What's this? Transfer authorization for patients, okay. Mark of psychiatric systems, not massive, okay. Caution, level triple black security protocols, including chemical restraint, physical restraint, and separate adaptive hyperbaric chambers are to be used at all time in transit. Chemical stimulation is highly recommended for all personnel within 500 meters of the patients. Attempts at communication should be assumed to be hallucinations and disregarded. Facial disfigurement should not be taken as a sign of lost acuity. They are physically blind but not unseeing. Security clearance for Project Warrider will not apply to information regarding 3 patients. New security clearance will be issued and appropriate protocol assigned. So... What? The patients are blind but not blind. This looks a lot like the first part of the game, but those stuffs here, I can't remember those, and I can't even try to open them doors. So gonna check the rooms. Maybe I'll find something interesting, I guess. Hello, is this? I like the music. It's such a hopeful music. Before I get, I don't know, shot to death or something like that. What's here? Why are those all these doors locked like that? I mean, that's kind of weird. Library. Is this the... Yeah, this is the first floor. So, a lot of memories here, actually. Damn! And this is where Miles was, and he opened this door that's now apparently closed. And in the end part of the game, he went through there to get the key. Well, that's something. And the light. Why? Oh, the military finally came in, so this is long before Miles is dead. And they barricaded the doors so people can't escape. Oh, I see. Okay, so I need to just go down a floor. This door is locked, and that's the creepy basement. And I see the exit there.
Mr. Park, how the fuck are you still alive?
What?
Make a deal? You help me, I'll help you.
Jeremy Blair, my supervisor. A man who would see me skinned, salted, and raped for a promotion and few martinis. Injured, dying if he's not already dead. I'm trying to feel sorry for him, really I am. But there's no way in hell he's stopping me from getting out of this godforsaken place. I'm coming home, Lisa. Yes, I am coming.
I'm stuck like a pig.
I don't actually give up flying them. But you beat me with a stick! When Chris was coming, I mean, what? Why would I help you? Can I not? I think something bad's gonna happen. I just have a feeling that, like, that's not... Can I go in other places? Or that's the only way to go? Every time there's something like, okay, you just do this and you're gonna be fine. It's not fine. Every goddamn time. Can I just broke one of those windows? I don't know. Oh god, here I go.
Help me up.
No, I won't. Oh! I see! Oh, what? No! 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 Not again! Why? You stupid piece of... Go, come on, go! You are... Oh god! Oh! What? What? Oh! Yes! 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 Yes, go fuck yourself! Yes! Thank you, All Rider! Thank you, are my hero! Oh, that was so nice! Oh, that was so nice. But I'm stabbed. Can I... And I... My leg is... I don't know. Crude? Can I just go? Oh, come on. Don't tell me you're gonna die here. Come on. Come on. Come on, easy. Yeah, stand up. No more military. No more nothing. Please, just let me go. Just let me go. Oh, God. Oh. Thank you. This is so beautiful. Can I just jump in one of those military trucks and run away? I'm feeling so good. Something bad probably gonna happen again, but this is so good. It just broke down the door. And this looks pretty goddamn nice with the sun rising and all that. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, this looks amazing. And here's Miles' car. Oh. Oh. He left his key in the ignition. Yes. I'm gonna finally escape. Not me, Miles, but you know. What's that? Oh, just some leaves, okay. Oh, that's not leaves? What's that? What the fuck? No, go, oh, goddamn car! Oh, go! What are you doing? Come on, just, oh yes, that's the stuff.
Yes.
I don't understand what that was. Button.
There's no going back, Mr. Park. There's enough hard evidence in that video file to make a world of shit for our friends at Murkoff. You got out of Mount Massive alive, and we've done everything in our power to cover your tracks. But our enemies are twitching and malicious corporate paranoiacs with resources you're too moral to imagine. You won't be the only target. Anyone you care about, your wife, your child, there'll be nothing to Murkoff but ways to hurt you. I need you to understand the bridge you're crossing here. You will do irrevocable damage to the company. You might even get close to something like justice. But once you click upload, your life is over. Everyone you love is fucked. But it's the right thing to do. Is hurting Murkoff worth that much to you?
Oh God. Oh God, this is actually a moral choice. Just upload? I mean, I don't actually have a choice. Can I not upload? Back off? Well, let's try to reason this actually a bit. So, they kind of put a lot of mental patients together and they try to brainwash them and use them as hosts for some nanobit stuff just to, I don't know, make them live longer and be happier, and that's just awful. Taking advantage of so many people that had mental conditions, and that's just unexcusable through any point, and They're a giant company. If I'm not doing this right now, they would just do that again, but better. Better for them, I mean, not better in general. And that's just a big no-no. And I can just take my family and be on the run, and I know that... I mean, I'm okay with sacrificing my life for a greater good, but my family's... We can have name changes and live in, I don't know, another city. Try to raise potatoes. And my kids, but mostly potatoes. So, actually, I think I'd press the button. Actually, I think I will. In real life, I mean. And that's it? What was that thing at the gate? Oh man. Oh, this was such a cool DLC, man. Oh my god. This was very, very nice done. I mean, all the action was packed so tightly. And at every corner, there was something happening. Here's the jump scare. Here's someone chasing you. He's trying to eat you. He's trying to marry you. All those stuffs happening in such small time frames. It was nuts. And it always kept you on edge. I mean, there was no time where I was, okay, now I'm just walking around and nothing's gonna happen. No, every goddamn time. And at the end, when I thought, okay, this military guy is gonna help me, and I walked 2 meters ahead and I heard shooting and kill everyone that's still moving. Damn! And you're finally out, and everything is good, and that guy tells you, well, if you press that button, all you know and love is gonna die. Like, you have no chill in this game, man, and I love that about it. This DLC was such a great stuff. I mean, I played that as a standalone game, for fuck's sake. That was so well done. And all the ambient, the music, and did you just see that rising sun that was at the end there? That was brilliant. I don't know, I just like this game so much, and the DLC just brought a good layer upon it, brought a good sunshine. But yeah, and I don't know, I'm in awe right now because I can't believe it's done. I wanted to play more, actually. I want that to be like a bigger game, but it's just DLC. I mean, there's Outlast 2 now out. I don't know if it's following the same idea, but if it's as awesome as this, I can't wait to play it. But I wanted to reach this point to say, if you guys like this playthrough of Outlast and the DLC and everything, and you will wish me to make more horror games playthroughs like those, you can tell me in comments what would you like to see and what would you like me to approach. And I'm gonna play, man. I don't know what to tell you, but I'm gonna play. I really enjoyed this experience, and that was so much fun. And I hope you were here with me too, enjoying that as well. But yeah, the music stopped, and now I feel like a bit awkward. So. I think I'm gonna end it here. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I really hope you liked it. If you want to support me, you can tell your friend about those videos. You can tell, I don't know, if you didn't like, you can tell your friends and make fun of me together. That strengthens a friendship bond between two people. So yeah. And maybe give a like. I don't know. I don't know, man. You do whatever you want. It's your life. It's your life. But anyway, cheers to you, and we'll see each other next time. Bye!